Good morning. Welcome back to Outlook Portland. I'm your host, David Bragdon. My guests are Aaron Flynn of the Portland Development Commission and Tim Priest from Greenlight Greater Portland. We've just been talking about the proverbial or mythical, perhaps, PhD who is pouring coffee at a coffee place in Portland, and that led to the discussion of, do we have a mismatch between opportunity and workforce here? Aaron?
What I'm hearing anecdotally, and I don't have the numbers at my fingertips to support this claim, but I do think, I don't know if it's the PhD, but I will say, if you have a PhD in engineering, you're probably going to be able to find a job here. If you have a master's degree in art history, you might have a harder time finding your dream job. So we do have a lot of creative types, the creative class, if you will, coming to Portland for quality of life, for the sort of creative bohemian lifestyle that we're known for. I think a lot of these people are underemployed. At the same time, I am hearing constantly from employers that they cannot find skilled workers. So I think what we have is a mismatch between the demand for jobs in the labor market and who's moving to Portland. So one of the things we need to work on is better marketing those jobs that are available. And we have, I believe, a lot of work in product design, in architecture, in manufacturing, that's high level work where there could be a connection made between supply and demand, but I don't think we have those mechanisms in place today. And we need to work on that.
Tim, how do you say it from the private sector side? I mean, you represent a private sector organization, your board of directors, primarily the larger corporations here in town. How do you look at those workforce issues in terms of either the creative class and the needs of employers here?
Well, we just went through a fairly extensive process to determine what skill sets we had here in the region. So, you know, what type of workers do we have? What are they doing now? And then what are the demand for those occupations going forward? So we have some insight into that. And one of the things that we stumbled over was that we've got a real concentration of electronics services workforce. That's people working for the Intels and the SCH Americas, you know, the big chip manufacturers. But however, that industry is contracting nationally. It's still holding on here in Portland. It's still very stable.
Do you see that as a strong part of our future here?
Well, the workforce, certainly. And I think we're always going to be a chip manufacturing town, but that's not going to be a huge growth sector for us going forward. The growth for us is in alternative energy product manufacturing. So it's solar, which uses the same materials as the chip manufacturers and the same workforce. It's wind and other forms of energy. So I think that's the growth for us, and so we've got a challenge to migrate workers from one industry to the next.
Does the skill set here match with what the needs of employers are going to be in the future?
Yes. I mean, certainly in the alternative energy, the skill sets match very well. So we're excited about that.
What about manufacturing more generally? You know, this is maybe urban myths. We're dealing in a lot of urban myths here, but that I've heard large manufacturers say that they have a workforce, of course, for the most part in their 50s, some of them going toward retirement. These are hardcore, you know, manufacturing jobs, welding, sheet metal, and all that sort of thing, that they're actually having a hard time recruiting for, and these are good paying jobs. Do you see that? Do you see that as a problem here?
Yeah, certainly that's something that Manufacturing 21 has flagged as an issue.
Now, who's Manufacturing 21, if you want to just describe who they are?
It's a public-private partnership of manufacturers and public officials who are working to address the workforce shortage in manufacturing.
So we're in a situation where we have a workforce shortage in the same geographic area where there are also people who are unemployed. Is somebody not connecting the dots here?
I think one of the challenges, frankly, is that manufacturing has a PR problem. And Manufacturing 21 has acknowledged this. Kids today don't
think... A PR problem with the public or with students?
With young people. Young people don't think of going into manufacturing anymore. They think of Detroit. They think of all of our production going over to China. They don't see a future for themselves in manufacturing. And here in Oregon, we have a remarkable concentration of manufacturers that pay good wages, highly skilled jobs, but I don't think people, again, are making that connection. So we need to do a better job of marketing what kinds of jobs actually exist in manufacturing.
They're actually very good paying jobs as well. And, you know, just to sort of contrast the Portland Metro with Detroit, for example, you know, Detroit and many other major cities across the U.S. have had a huge decline in manufacturing. Portland's one of the only metros that's continued to add manufacturing jobs over the last 10 years.
What are the factors that drive that here? Why, if, because we hear a lot that the United States is in this post-industrial period, it's moving offshore, yet I think you're right, it is a strong sector here in Portland. What are underlying fundamentals here?
You know, it's different for each company, but the companies here have really found a unique niche where they're able to provide value at a reasonable cost and can compete globally. And you know, I think it's different for every company and how they do that. But I was really excited to see that because I think a successful metro has to be one that can attract knowledge workers, that has industries of the future, but also makes things because wealth is created through you know, product manufacturing,
making things, and selling them to people in other places. Exactly. So I want to talk about global competition when we come back, and ask when we come back after this break, whether globalization is a good thing or a bad thing for Portland. Mm. So we'll follow up on that when we come back after this break.
Outlook Portland will continue in a moment.